What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we'll be talking about 7 signs of insufficient fat intake. So let's get started. So we're just gonna jump right into it and start with tip number one. The number one sign that you are not consuming enough fat in your diet is the loss of your period. Estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone are the hormones that regulate menstruation. Now, if your dietary fat intake is too low, your body is going to have a very challenging time creating these sex hormones. Having a normal reproductive system and having regular periods is actually really important. Unfortunately, this is all too common with fitness competitors and a lot of diets that have a tendency to go way too low in fat for way too long. As a result of this, it can actually hinder your metabolism, it can slow your metabolic rate, and give you some longer term issues. Some of my clients have actually come to me after being on crazy low amounts of fat for prolonged periods of time, no longer able to get their period, and we've needed to reverse diet them and really work backwards to get that in order. So you want to be careful if you've been too low and too fat for too long. I say too low, I would say, is probably under 40 grams of fat for a prolonged period of time. Prolonged, I would say any period longer than 2 to 3 weeks. Last but not least, if you have missed 2 or more cycles, make sure you visit your OBGYN to get professional advice because that is not normal. Now, tip number 2 that you are not getting enough fat in your diet is going to be dry skin. Now, a common sign, again, is a dry, flaky skin texture. If you are experiencing this, and you're not getting enough fat in your diet, what's supposed to happen is your skin is supposed to look supple, vibrant, moisturized internally. And even with the best moisturizers on the planet, it's not going to impact your skin on a cellular level. So you want to increase your dietary fats. And if you are struggling to get your fat from real whole foods, even try taking a fat supplement like a fish oil, MCT, a coconut oil capsule, something to make sure that you are getting fat to your cell membranes, which give your cells that nice, vibrant, youthful glow about you. Sign number 3 is dry hair or hair loss. So just like the skin, good health is addressed internally, and you cannot correct for poor hair health just with products alone. And anytime you notice a drastic change in your hair texture or something happening with your hair, you always want to look at your diet first. One thing that I personally use is I always have a fat supplement with omega-3 fatty acids every single day. It makes a big difference internally. And the thing is, guys, don't waste your money on all the crazy hair products. You need to impact your hair health from within. Now, it's going to make a huge difference, so don't skimp out on your fats because it's going to make your hair healthy and shiny from within. The 4th sign that you are not getting enough fat is excessive hunger. Fat intake is so crucial to boosting your satiety because it helps to slow the absorption of foods and nutrients, and it also helps to lower the overall glycemic index and impact spiking of your blood sugar because it allows the body to absorb nutrients at a much slower rate. So if you are feeling excessively hungry and just you eat and you don't have any sense of satisfaction, you will want to add some more fat to your meals to help slow that rate of your blood sugar spiking back up, and fat helps to lower that rate and keeps you fuller longer. So the 5th reason you are not getting enough fat in your diet is mental fatigue. The brain is actually made up of 60% fat, and your body, of all the calories you consume in a day, 20 to 25% of them go just for mental function. So if you are struggling with cognitive loading and you can just not think clearly, you're having brain fog and you're having a hard time concentrating, It is most likely because you are not getting enough fat in your diet. I remember times on contest prep where at the very end of my peak week, on my very low fat day, where my brain just did not feel right. And granted, it was for a day or so, but if you're doing this for prolonged periods of time, you are not going to feel right mentally and you will feel fatigued if you go too low in fat for too long. Now, reason six is an inability to lose weight. So a lot of people start dropping fat to help support fat loss, and it does help to a certain extent. But if you do this and go too low for too long and just eat too few of calories, your body's going to slow down your total metabolic rate and it's going to be even more challenging. So if you're at a complete plateau, it could be because your fat levels are way too low and you may need to increase them. Last but not least is number seven, vitamin deficiencies. So there are a lot of vitamins that are only fat soluble, meaning they are absorbed when you consume fat. So if you're not consuming sufficient amounts of fat, your body's gonna have an inability to absorb vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K, and vitamin A. So it's going to make a big difference. So vitamin A deficiency, that's going to impact your vision, that is going to impact growth and your bones. This vitamin A is naturally found in meat, whole milk, fish, eggs, butter, and dark leafy greens. Now, vitamin D deficiency, it tends to result in weaker bones as a result of your body not being able to absorb calcium. Vitamin D is naturally found in fattier fish like salmon, so if you are not getting enough of that in real whole food, you may want to consider supplementation of it. Now, vitamin E deficiency, this can drastically compromise your immune system. It protects against damage from free radicals, and this vitamin is naturally found in nuts, olive oil, seeds, as well as dark green veggies. Last but not least is vitamin K. You won't be able to absorb enough vitamin K if you're not eating enough fat. And vitamin K, being low in it, can result in GI issues. It can result in heavy periods, and this nutrient is best absorbed when you have enough fat intake. It's naturally found in cruciferous vegetables, dark leafy greens, as well as veggies and soybeans. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you need help dialing in your macros, you're not sure how much fat you should be taking, I suggest order a custom meal plan or a one-on-one consultation, link below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.